Shalom, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and welcome to Biblical Hebrew Foundation. Does God and can God still heal? And if God still heals, why are people still sick? If you're born again, if you're under the blood of Yeshua, Jesus, if you believe that he died on the cross on the tree for your sins, rose on the third day, and by his blood you have full redemption of sins and eternal life, then the Bible says that you have divine benefits. Let's turn our Bible to the book of Tehillim, Psalms 103, verses 1 to 3. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. In other words, don't forget all his benefits. So we see that as believers in Yeshua, in Jesus, we have divine benefits. Let's look at verse 3. Who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases. Very important to realize that these two benefits are in the same verse. Forgives all iniquities and heals all diseases. Now there's something very, very important that I want to bring out. It's easier to accept the first part, forgives all iniquities, than it is to accept the second part, heals all diseases. Because of health problems, because of friends or family members that have health problems, maybe some family who have health problems, but we know that by grace, God forgives all of our sins. So we need to read these Bible verses in context and be true to ourselves. Here we have a Bible verse in the Bible, Psalms 103, that says he forgives all our iniquities and he heals all our diseases. Is the verse true? Of course it is. Everything in the Bible from Genesis to Revelation is the true word of God. Is that truth still for today? Was there a time where God heals all diseases, but he doesn't do it anymore? Does the Bible say that God still forgives, but he doesn't heal anymore? Or sometimes he heals? But if we read it in context, it's in the same verse. We can't put a slash there and divide it. It's in the same verse. God forgives all iniquities and he heals all diseases. The question is, if the Bible says that God heals all diseases, then why? And I'm sure you can fill out the whys. And we all have someone's name that we can put in the why. It's very important that you open your Bible, take some notes, and go through these Bible verses that I'm going to go through with you, and we're going to get a context and understanding what this all means. There's a lot of teachings out there and a lot of misunderstandings, but if we focus here on the Word of God through the power of the Holy Spirit, we're going to understand. I'm going to explain to you why this Bible verse is true and why sometimes as believers we still get sick. And I'm going to do it by asking three very difficult questions, and I'm going to answer the questions. Question number one is why? And I'm just using these as examples. Why am I not healed? And that's a very good question. If you're a believer and you're going through a health situation right now, if the Bible says that God heals all diseases, why am I not healed? Why is my friend not healed? Why is my family member not healed? Another very difficult question is, why did my friend die? Why did my parent die? Why did my sibling die? And here's one that's so tough, it's hard for me even to say, because I don't want to just say it and be insensitive. I can't even imagine someone going through this. Why did my child die? If God heals all diseases, why? Again, it's very important that I bring this out again. We just read in Psalms 103, verse 3, that God forgives all your iniquities and heals all your diseases in the same verse. Remember, verse 2 says, don't forget his benefits. So we know that part of the benefits of being a believer in Yeshua by grace is God forgives all your iniquities and he heals all your diseases. Divine benefits. Now we're going to examine some scriptures now, and we're going to see that this is actually a pattern in scripture where God puts forgiveness and healing in the same verse. Let's turn our Bible to the book of Isaiah chapter 33, verse 24. And the inhabitant will not say, I am sick. The people who dwell in it will be forgiven their iniquity. Now this Bible verse here is talking about Zion, where the gathered worshipers will be. Healing and forgiveness in the same verse. It's important to understand that biblical pattern for us to understand the verse in Psalms 103. Let's look at Isaiah chapter 53, Shayahu Nun Gimel, Isaiah 53 verse 5. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him. And by his stripes we are healed. Notice here again, forgiveness and healing in the same verse. This is a biblical pattern. He took our punishment, he bore our sins, and by his stripes we are healed. This is an Old Testament messianic prophecy scripture. But everything in the Old Testament is a shadow of the New. Let's turn our Bibles to 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24. Who himself bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sins, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes you were healed. Once again, we see forgiveness and healing in the same verse. The verse says that Yeshua, Jesus, bore our sins on the tree on the cross. If you believe that Jesus, Yeshua, God, bore your sins on the cross, on the tree, the question has to be asked, did he also bear your sickness? Because that's what the Bible says, that he bore your sins and he bore your sicknesses. In order to answer the question why, we need to understand this biblically, this concept, in order to understand why. Let's turn to Isaiah 53 verse 4. Surely he has borne, see the word borne, our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. It says he has borne our griefs. The word griefs in Hebrew means sickness. In Hebrew, it's the word chalinu, achen, chalinu hunasa, which means sickness. So the word in Hebrew is sickness. So in this context, the word grief in Hebrew is the word chalinu, which is the word sickness, the root word from chole, sick in Hebrew. There are 24 passages in the Old Testament that speak about, that use the word sickness. And 20 times out of 24, the context is sickness. Surely he has borne our griefs. In Hebrew, the word means sickness, chalinu. And if we go to the New Testament, we can actually see the quote of this verse. Because everything in the Old Testament is a shadow of the New. It's all one book from Genesis to Revelation. Matthew chapter 8, verse 16 and 17. When evening had come, they brought to him many who were demon-possessed, and he cast out the spirits with a word, and healed all who were sick. Now watch this here in Matthew 8, 17. That it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, he himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. Some translations will say diseases. The Bible says that. And here in Matthew, it's quoting from Isaiah 53. He bore our sins on the cross, on the tree. He bore our sicknesses, our diseases, on the cross, on the tree. But why do we still get sick? Let's have a look why, according to the Bible. For iniquities, the word would be sins, heals all diseases, the word would be sicknesses. When Yeshua bore our sin and our sickness on the cross, on the tree, we need to look at the three aspects to understand the three aspects of how he bore our sins. Here are three very important words. Number one, he bore the penalty, he bore the power, and he even bore the presence of sin and sickness. So the penalty, the power, and the presence of sin and sickness. Jesus, Yeshua, bore the penalty of your sin. There's no doubt about that, the full penalty. But remember, when Jesus reveals himself to John in the book of Revelation, here's what he tells John, and I'm paraphrasing. I was, I am, and I will be. Who was, who is, and who is to come. Yeshua, Jesus, God, is past, present, and future. He is eternal. We have been saved, we are being saved, and we will be saved. And I'll explain what I mean. We have been saved by his grace. We are being made whole, being Yeshua-like, Christ-like. The sanctification process. We're in that sanctification process now. As we grow more in our faith here on this earth and prepare ourselves as the bride of Jesus Yeshua for his second coming. And we will be saved in the kingdom for eternity one day. We were saved. We are in the sanctification process. And we will be saved for eternity with him in the kingdom. Let's talk about sin. We have already been saved from the penalty of sin. If you believe in Jesus, Yeshua, if you've called on His name as Lord and Savior, one day we will be saved from the presence of sin. In heaven, there's no sin. I'm going to say it again. One day we're going to be saved from the presence of sin because in heaven, there's no sin. There's no grief. There's no sorrow. There's no sickness. But right now, we live in a fallen world. And because sin is still present in this world, sometimes believers still fall under the power of sin. It's a sanctification process. He also bore the power. That's why believers get victory over sin through the blood of the Lamb. But sometimes, because we live in a fallen world, the believer falls under the power of sin. Why? Because sin is still present in this world. Very important to realize, Jesus Yeshua also bore our sicknesses on the cross. But because sickness is still present in this fallen world, sometimes, even as a believer, we fall under the power of sickness. I don't need to convince you that we live in an evil world. Sin's presence is still here. So because we live in an evil world, because evil is still present, sometimes even believers fall under the power of sin, which is because we live in a fallen world. So this answers the question, why? How can you say Yeshua heals all my diseases, but my father or my mother died of cancer? Because we still live in the presence of evil in this world. But that does not mean that he did not bear the penalty. I want to say something very, very important because I've heard a lot of misunderstandings. And it's very important that I bring this out. And I pray that the Holy Spirit reveals this to you. God will never punish you for your sins because Yeshua, Jesus, already paid the penalty. Yeshua bore your sins on the cross. Hallelujah. You know what that means? If you're sick, it's not God punishing you. I'm going to say it again. If you're sick, it's not God punishing you. He does not use sickness to punish His children because Yeshua, Jesus, bore sickness on the tree on the cross for us. And if anybody is preaching anything else, it's a lie from Satan. God will not use sickness to punish His children. Let's turn our Bibles to Exodus chapter 15, verse 26. I will put none of the diseases on you which I have brought on the Egyptians, for I am the Lord who heals you. This is a foretelling of grace. So the first question was why? We've answered that. Now how? How does a person receive healing? It's actually very simple. How did you receive forgiveness of sins? Remember that forgiveness of sins and healing are in the same verse. You receive forgiveness by grace through faith. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. So by grace you've been saved through faith, not of works. And according to James, Yaakov, the half-brother of Yeshua, that's faith that is active. But we get saved by grace. Something else I want to bring out that's very, very important. Please hear me on this. You are not saved by faith. We're saved by grace through faith. How do you get healed? By grace through faith. And many times I've heard people say, God doesn't heal anymore. He's healed for thousands of years. Only when Jesus was on earth there was healing, and all of a sudden God stopped healing. Or God just forgot how to heal people. There's the extreme out there that teaches that. It's absolutely amazing for anybody to believe that. It's actually a works mentality, because what it's saying, that if you eat right, take care of yourself and exercise, then you will be healed. But health is a gift from God. Now, in the same way salvation is a gift from God, we need to steward that grace well. So that means, yes, we need to exercise, we need to eat well, we need to take care of our bodies. I'm not saying we don't need to. I personally know people who have eaten very well and have exercised and still died of a disease. So it's not by works. It's by grace. Our health is by grace. And then there's the other extreme that teaches if you have enough faith, you'll be healed. You just need to have more faith. There was a brother here in Israel that was sick with cancer, and he wanted to go to a place that focuses on healing. So he went to a big conference in the UK. And this brother came back and he was so hurt and he was so damaged. And he said, Zev, they actually yelled at me and screamed at me that I don't have enough faith and that's why I'm not getting healed. And they even told me, you must have some sin in your life. Now here's what the problem really was. They were embarrassed because he was not healed in the conference, and it made him look bad. Instead of focusing on Yeshua, Jesus, they were focusing on themselves. It made him look bad that they were praying for the brother and he wasn't healed. Please, if a person is suffering, don't ever put guilt and condemnation on them. Because we live in an evil, evil world. We live in a fallen world. And as believers in Yeshua, we need to give him love, not to scream at him that he doesn't have enough faith. So faith and works, those are the two extremes. You are not healed because you have enough faith, and you're not healed because you do everything right. Works. Because you can't do everything right, and none of us have perfect faith. You can be healed by grace. Through faith, we can receive. Let me show you a beautiful scripture. I love this scripture. Luke 5. You remember when they cut a hole in the roof and they let the man down? And Yeshua, Jesus, said to him, this crippled man, he told him, your sins are forgiven. And the Pharisees were getting very upset and saying, who does he think he is to forgive sins? And I'm paraphrasing. And Yeshua actually asks a question. You know Yeshua, Jesus, was Jewish. He asks a lot of questions. Luke 5, verse 23. Which is easier to say, your sins are forgiven, or to say, rise up and walk? We've been asking God questions. God, why? And how? But God wants to ask us a question today. Listen to this question from Yeshua, from Jesus. Yeshua said this. Which is easier, to say your sins are forgiven, or to say, rise up and walk? Which is easier, for God to forgive all your iniquities, or for God to heal all your diseases? The answer is, they're both easy for God. Yeshua, God, can do them both. So I want to encourage you today. If you're going through something, the same way you received forgiveness, I want you to receive healing in the name of Yeshua, Jesus, by grace through faith. This is an important biblical revelation. We need to receive health the same way we receive forgiveness, by grace. We're not worthy of it. I gave it to you. It's a gift by grace. Psalms 103, it's a benefit. Don't forget his benefits. If you're a child of the living God, if you're under the blood of Yeshua Jesus, if you're born again, if you're grafted into spiritual Israel, if you're grafted into the olive tree, then you have a divine benefit by grace. Just like we tell ourselves, I'm forgiven, we need to tell ourselves, I'm healthy. We need to proclaim the word, the promise in the scripture. If you believe that you've been forgiven, then you need to believe that you've been healed. Many times we see people that are health nuts and they really take care of themselves, and they really work out, and they really eat healthy, and they die early. We need to remember, it's a gift from God. Every day that we breathe, every heartbeat, every second is a gift from God. And we should be praying for health. Many times we pray for healing a lot, but we don't pray for health. We need to pray for health. Every day, we need to pray for health. Pray for health for your family. Pray for health for yourself, for your friends. We need to pray for health, not just pray for healing. And we receive it by grace through faith. The last question is, what if? What if I'm not healed? What if my friend's not healed? What if my child is not healed? What if my mother or father are not healed? And I'm going to give you the answer. We're going to trust God anyway. Here's how Paul, under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, the Ruach HaKodesh, answered this question. Philippians chapter 1, verse 20. Christ, Yeshua, will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. God forgives all our iniquities, and he heals all our diseases. We still live in a fallen, evil world, but he is faithful, and we're going to trust him no matter what. I pray this teaching has blessed you, as it has blessed me over the years. Let's continue to stand together, work the harvest together as the one new man, Ephesians 2:15. Bring the gospel back to Jerusalem and go home.
And for Zion's sake, we will not keep silent. Isaiah 62, verse 1. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not remain quiet. Till her vindication shines out like the dawn, her salvation like a blazing torch. And we know that the word for salvation in Hebrew is the word Yeshua, Jesus, her Yeshua, like a blazing torch.
Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Israel in the mighty name of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Aryeh Yehuda, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Jesus Yeshua, Amen.
Every knee shall bow, and every tongue will confess that Yeshua, Jesus, is God. Hallelujah. Amen.